Our world is full of color, especially when you look into the sky. And not just the sky itself, but also the animals that call it their home. Birds, beautiful flying splashes of color circling over our heads. They need bright and flashy colors for attracting a mate or to compete for territory. But have you ever asked yourself where their bright and vivid colors actually come from? And was Humboldt right? Are tropical birds more colorful than their northern cousins? Let's dive directly into the feathers and check out pigments and light reflecting structures to see how color is created. Birds are weird, beautiful, and fascinating creatures. They've always had an influence on human creativity and served as inspiration for art and science. Alexander von Humboldt, a famous German naturalist, mentioned something that his two contemporaries, Charles Darwin and Alfred Russel Wallace, also noticed on their travels. The closer one gets to the tropics, the greater the variety of structures, graceful forms, and color combinations. According to these explorers, plants and animals both displayed more vivid colors the closer they got to the equator. It took scientists over a century to prove Humboldt's theory. In 2022, after analyzing more than 24,000 pictures of over 4,500 bird species around the globe, the scientists came to an interesting conclusion. Our channel may not have 24,000, but it still has a lot of good videos. Help our channel grow. Like, share, and subscribe, and also check out some more videos of ours afterwards. We'd greatly appreciate it. But for real, the scientists, with some elaborate mathematical color analysis, found out that, yes, tropical birds are more colorful than their temperate cousins. On average, tropical birds are about 30% more colorful, showing more intense colors and also a broader tone spectrum. But even though tropical birds are more vibrant, many birds all over the world show a lot of color. So how do birds create their vibrant and shining colors? A lot has to do with genes, microstructures, pigments, and light. To understand that better, let's take a quick look at how light and color are connected. Our sun emits light, and not just white light, but all kinds of different colored light. Light travels as a wave, and every color we see is light traveling on a different wavelength. When we look at a flamingo's plumage, we just see the pink light that's reflecting back to our eyes. In the flamingo's case, pigments are responsible for this. Pigments are chemical compounds that reflect light of a specific wavelength and absorb the rest. Result? We see color. All the different wavelengths that we can see are called the visible spectrum. Interestingly, birds can see an even broader spectrum. They are tetrachromats, meaning they have four different photoreceptors or cones in their eyes. Humans only have three, and because of that, birds can also see ultraviolet light. But back to how birds create their color. Let's look at this bright fellow, Bernd the bird, and where he gets his different colors from. As we already had pink with flamingos, let's start with that. Flamingos are famous for their pink feathers, but they don't start out pink. The chicks are quite literally gray ducklings. They gain their color much later in life, and they gain it through their food. Flamingos feed mainly on tiny crustaceans, which in turn feed on red algae. And eating the shrimp turns the flamingos pink. Or rather, the pigments originating in the algae color the birds. Like flamingos, Bernd and many other birds have some reddish feathers. And, also like flamingos, the color comes from their food. Carotenoids are the pigments responsible for yellow, orange, and red tones. Animals can't produce carotenoids themselves and need to get them through their food, like berries, fruits, or shrimp. Some of these carotenoids are put into feathers. Others are metabolized and changed to show different color shadings. Interesting side fact. Parrots, probably the colorful stereotype, don't use carotenoids. Even though they do consume them, they don't need them for coloring their feathers. Instead, parrots produce their own pigments called psittacofulvins, and they look just as spectacular. Back to Bernd. He also sports brown and gray colors. Another important pigment is in play here, melanin. Melanins are responsible for shades of brown, grays, and blacks, and can also be found in human hair and skin. Birds produce melanins themselves, directly in their skin and feathers. But melanin isn't only there for color. It also enhances the mechanical strength of feathers. That's why feathers at the front of the wings and at their tips are often darker. Now, those are the main pigments birds use for color. But what about Bernd's greens and blues? Well, there aren't really any green and blue pigments readily available in nature that animals could use. But luckily, there is also another way to reflect and make color, via structural coloration. A bird's blue is created via microstructures in its feathers. When the light hits the feather, it bounces around between these tiny structures and then is absorbed by an underlying dark melanin layer. Only one specific wavelength is reflected. A peacock feather is blue for that very reason. Blue-colored light is reflected back to our eyes. This is also how their feathers appear shiny and iridescent. The angle at which the light hits the eye makes them shimmer. But there's more that birds achieve with structural colors, like shining whites and darkest blacks. And green? There's only one animal that produces a green pigment, Turacos. They create porphyrins, pigments that color blood red and chlorophyll green. For the rest of the avian world, it takes a bit more effort. They have to combine pigments and structural coloration to achieve greens. Simply speaking, they mix yellow pigments with a blue structure to create green feathers. This is how birds create their own rainbow, a complex and beautiful kaleidoscope of colors. But still, the question remains, why do they get more and more colorful the deeper into the tropical south we go? The scientists that proved Humboldt's theory also have some ideas as to why exactly the hot and humid rainforest is filled with brighter colors. Essentially, the tropics have a higher net energy productivity, meaning there is more food available in the ecosystem as a whole. Additionally, the tropics are more climate stable. There are no seasons to really have an impact on when trees produce fruit and seeds. This lets birds spend more energy on sporting a lavish plumage, as there is more food available throughout the year. So, with more energy to spend, they can wear the fanciest and most ostentatious feather dresses every day. And with that, they have a better chance of securing a mate. Thanks for watching. Leave some nice fancy colors in the comments if you enjoyed this video, and please like, share, and subscribe. Until next time.